Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Richard Taylor Woods.
Good afternoon, everyone. Come on, in typical British fashion, good afternoon, everyone. That's better. Well, I am Richard Taylor Woods. It's lovely to be here. May I say, what a wonderful room it is here. It's fantastic here, isn't it? It reminds me of Buckingham Palace back home in London, doesn't it, hey? Oh, so ladies and gentlemen, my name is Richard Taylor Woods, and I'm part of the British Barbers Association events team. It's our pleasure and honour to be presenting to you today, and we're very excited to be sharing with you the very best of British barbering. I'm going to wander back up stage here just a little bit. I'm going to invite onto stage two very special gentlemen. So first of all, ladies and gentlemen, joining me on the stage, we've got BBA Creative Director Chris Foster, and we've also got BBA Educator Eric Lander, everyone. Please give them a round of applause. Here they come. Now, these gentlemen are some of the UK's most talented barbers and educators. Now, over the next 20 minutes or so, the BBA team is going to share with you a varied mixture of advanced and some classic barbering skills while showing you some of the latest trends in men's hairdressing and barbering. And we'd like to start by showing you a short video which inspired the first segment of the latest collection, The King's Row. Well, there you go. Wasn't that inspiring? I almost expected James Bond or Miss Moneypenny to appear in one of these balconies right up here. Fantastic. Okay, so I'll tell you what, Chris, can you give us the inspiration behind the collection and how that's going to translate into the styles and the looks that you're going to be presenting on your model today?
Richard, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for the opportunity to come here and present before you guys our collection, which is King's Row. My name is Chris Foster, and I am been fortunate to be the creative director for some of the largest shows in Moscow Fashion Week, New York Fashion Week, and London Fashion Week. And King's Row collection takes inspiration from Savile Row, the iconic street in London, where British men would get their suits tailored and their outfits crafted to their body shape. Today's collection is Huntsman. This is what we're going to produce today. Now, Huntsman, again, we're looking at classic tailoring. So we're taking, lending things from the whole bespoke shape, and we're bespoking a haircut which will really suit my model, as well as Eric's model as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Chris. Shaken, not stirred. Hey, Chris.
Shaken and not stirred. I like that.
Okay, I'll let you get started on your model.
No worries.
Okay, so we're also extremely excited this afternoon to be sharing with you for the first time in North America here at the Waldorf Astoria in New York, and the first time to see the BBA Men's Grooming Range. Now, both Chris and Eric will be using some of the range on their models today. The range currently has 12 products. It was over 3 years in the making, and it was created with the knowledge and expertise of some of the best in the business of the male grooming industry in the UK. Okay, I can see that he's got started on his model as well, so I'm just going to wander over, introduce you to Eric. He's going to tell you a bit about himself and the work he's going to do today.
Thanks, Richard. So, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Eric Lander. I'm an educator for the BBA. I come from a family of hairdressers and barbers. My father taught me my five-year apprenticeship through barbering, and it's 30 years this year that I've been barbering, so kind of really excited to be here. The first thing I'd like to do is, again, as Chris said, just to thank you. Thank you for your time giving it up to us, and also to thank Interquaffer for allowing us to be on this stage with such influential people within our industry. So the BBA is all about education. We feel very passionate and enthusiastic about delivering education. We deliver it in such a way that it's very easy to understand, that people just kind of can take something home with them. So it's this is something which, as I say, Chris and I, as part of the BB Education team, we deliver education all over the world, and we're really excited to be here. So the other thing that we'd like to do is just announce that we are going to be doing three educational tours next year around North America for the BBA. So if anybody is interested in finding out about in-depth education, how we do it, why we do it, if there's alternative methods, please contact the guys at the stand, and we can give you a lot more information about that.
There we go. You just see the boys finish off their models there. Thanks very much. Just putting in some texturing clay, and Chris just finishing off. There we go. Lovely. These boys are fantastic. I really don't know how they do it so quickly as well. Looks fantastic. There we go, boys. That's our models one and two just to disappear there. Lovely. Excellent. Excellent. There you go, guys. A little wander around. Fantastic. Lovely. So we get models three and four coming out onto the catwalk, please, for the boys. There we go. So, and as they do, I'm going to be telling you a bit about the BBA. Here come the models. There you go, guys. Fantastic. So for those of you that don't know anything or very little about the BBA, let me give you some information. So it's now got over 10,000 members, okay? It's been going over 10 years. Now, 3,000 of those members are either barbershop owners, unisex salons, or male grooming spas and operations. Now, the BBA was the first real organization to give men's barbering and hairdressing a voice in the UK, and it's been a pioneer in establishing and improving standards, creating platforms, and recognizing and celebrating talent. But most importantly, it's about building a community, okay? So the BBA, it's a very exciting time at the moment. We're in huge demand all over the world to help either set up and support similar communities with education and strategies to grow. Okay. It probably would be fair to say that in the UK, and I'm sure over here in North America you've noticed it too, over probably about the last 3 to 5 years, it's becoming more apparent that men are more comfortable to increase their services and the time spent in the barbershop or the salon. They want to learn more about how to take care of themselves. And it's more than just kind of grabbing a shaving cream or a face cream off the shelf in the supermarket. You know, they want to become more educated. I'll tell you what, I'm going to hand you over to Chris again, and he's going to tell you what he thinks about that. Chris, it's yours.
Thank you very much, Richard. How you guys doing? That's really quiet. I like that. I like quiet audiences. Makes things, because you're looking, you're watching, which is great. Fantastic. So, guys, I don't know if you know, you must have seen on social media the influx and the kind of the renaissance of barbering. Have you seen that? Yeah, it has gone ballistic. And guys, you know, what's really changed is that the actual male grooming and barbering have got really proud about their trade and their craft. And I guess salon owners and those, you know, if you're already selling, you want to be able to get into this market, because trust me, it's a market that's really moving and moving forward very, very quickly. So the BBA's philosophy has been about the passion of educating our clients, not only just using products in the hair, but skincare, taking it a little bit further, really increasing what we provide for our clients in the salon. And that's really important for you guys, because ultimately it's the dollars in your till registers that really, really matter. Don't you think? Yeah? So one great way of doing that is really looking at getting a range, getting education, so your staff and your team can understand that to really grasp and get a hold of this market, you do need to, you know, just be a part of the actual action that's happening.
I agree. Part of the action, Chris. Part of the action. Eric, out of the whole range, all the products, tell us, what's your favorite product?
My favorite product is this one here, which is the BBA texturizing clay. With ingredients like volcanic ash, it gives it a really beautiful kind of matte finish in the hair. It's also really easy to work with. But there is a secret. And again, this is one of the things about products. You need to know, understand how they work, the different products, what they do. And with this one, A, you don't need too much. So again, it's a great selling point to the client, lasts quite a long time. The other one is that when you're actually using it, don't overwork it. I watch an awful lot of people use products and they keep going and going and going. And before you know it, you've just used too much of either the product or worked it too much into the hair. So with this, less is more.
Fantastic. There we can see Eric using some of the product, just drying off the hair there. Same as Chris going there. There'll just be 30 seconds or more just to finish it off. And then we'll present the models, showing them the styles that we've conjured up here on the stage today. There we go.
Seeing? Are you guys enjoying what you're seeing? Oh, you're quiet.
There we go. Looking lovely, Eric. Chris is nearly done there as well. Finishing touches. Just finishing off. Look at that.
I think another important thing as well about products is explaining to the client how to use them. This is our best advert. And when people see a guy with great looking hair, they want to know where it's been done. And as I say, if he can recreate our haircut using the right product, again, it's all a winner for everybody, really.
Fantastic. Winner for everyone, Eric. Fantastic. Nearly done there before we present our models to you. Sporting the BBA gowns as well this afternoon, all the way from England. Fantastic. How you getting on there, Chris?
Fantastic. Lovely. So what job. I'm going to use, I like your word fantastic. It's a fantastic word.
A lot of fantastic.
All right, brilliant. So, bit of our grooming. This is our finishing pomade. Just going to work that through the products, through my hands, just wear it onto the hair. We want to see that some shine. We want to see that pop. This is our Ripley collection, ladies and gentlemen. Ripley is really our soft, very kind of a pan-American, European type cut, this part of our collection. So again, much more softer lines, using movement and texture in the hair. Hope you guys enjoy that.
So. There we go. Fantastic, boys. Thank you, Chris. Once again for our models, ladies and gentlemen.
You're allowed to dance.
There we go. And also on the screen there, the squadron. Makes me want to join the RAF. What about anyone else, yeah? Get yourself down to JFK. There we go. Okay, so, I'll tell you what. Tell us a little bit about the squadron, Chris.
Okay. We're just going to see it now. Is our fashion forward collection. It's really looking where we can push men's hairdressing looking at future trends. Of course, we're borrowing from the classic. We're borrowing from those things that are, you know, what guys are wearing and selling. But we want to just push it a little bit further. We all are very creative people, aren't we, guys? Yeah, so we want to push it forward. We want to really look at where trends are going. So this is essentially something that you get off from a catwalk, but it can be adapted in your salons. We worked as very square masculine shape, but we kept the front a little bit longer. You're going to see this pop with the product.
Yeah, Chris, also I hear there's a competition. Very exciting. Tell us a little bit about the competition well.
Sorry, guys. Quickly about the competition. We have something in the UK called a BBA Hall of Fame. Now, the BBA Hall of Fame is a competition that's held online where we have voting that happens via the general public and those people who call in, as well as judges as well. So the BBA Hall of Fame, we want to offer it to one member of Intercoffer. So what you have to do, guys, if you go over to the booth, you get a bit more information. But essentially, what we want to do is fly one member of Intercoffer over to London to have an exclusive shoot with us in London, all expense paid, in a very nice hotel, I might add. So, oh, thank you. Get a clap for that. Awesome. So, you know, if you really want to know about this particular competition, please head over to the booth. The guys will give you so much more information about it. All right?
Thank you, Chris. That sounds amazing. It sounds like some lucky guy or gal is going to have a fantastic time over there in London. I hear there's a lot of talent around here, so I'm looking forward to seeing the entries. Okay, folks, let's let the boys finish these fantastic, cool new street looks, and we'll be back shortly.
Ladies and gentlemen, the British Barbers Association.
I'm not very technical, I'm not very synthesizer, I'm not very, you know, computer, graph, video screen, check the sound out.
Look at this!
And ladies and gentlemen, have it a nice hand for these great looks. The British Barbers Association. Please bring them back. Richard, Chris, and Eric. The British Barbers Association. BBA.
Forget it, brother. To the zombies of death, quit holding out, draw another breath. London calling, and I don't wanna shout.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the BBA, we'd just like to say thank you very much for letting us share with you today. If you want to know more about the guys and their education and the product line, please come and see us on the stand in the room next door just here. Thank you very much. Have a lovely afternoon. Good night. Bye.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, the BBA, British Barbers Association. Just a few moments.